They call it the world of robots, the planet inhabited only by machines. 30 or more mechanical objects that run around or that went through its sands, and that orbit or orbited above its very thin atmosphere. Some destroyed before they even began. Others that walked and dug for years before running out of luck, energy, and time. We're talking about Mars, of course. The great lure of our conquest cravings. The scientific dream of generations of astronomers. And the race to Mars has become so tumultuous in recent times that it can now be defined as a real siege. Right now, in fact, there are three missions in flight to the Red Planet, and it would have been four if technical impediments in recent months had not postponed the departure of the European probe. Three missions that will arrive all in February. Let's see how, and especially who. Every 2 years is the year of Mars. The optimal alignment between the Earth and the Red Planet, in fact, occurs every 26 months or so, when the ideal launch window opens to get there in just a few months. In May of 2018, for example, NASA's InSight mission took off. In March of 2016, the European ExoMars probe, and so on. This year, however, there have been three probes, and should have been four if at the last moment there had not been the forfeit of the joint Europe-Russia mission, launched to Mars during the 2020 launch window, opened in July. A crowding never seen before, due not only to the obligations imposed by the gravitational navigation, but also to precise political choices. By now, space is no longer only a field of technological innovation, but it is transforming more and more rapidly in an element of economic and strategic importance. The many private companies that have entered the sector of telecommunications, satellites, launch systems, or orbital infrastructures are a tangible sign of the challenges taking place. If billionaires such as Musk, Bezos, or Branson are committed to capture the future space markets, it's not surprising that several countries are deploying the best technologies to gain a place among the stars. Elon Musk wants to create a colony on the Red Planet to make humanity a multi-planetary species. And the United Arab Emirates do not hide the ambition to build a Martian city. Perhaps the interplanetary traffic of these days is the first sign of how the colonization of Mars is becoming a real social and political project. Returning to the news, on July 19th, departed from the Tanegashima Space Center in Japan, the probe Hope, in Arabic Al-Amal, the first Martian mission of the United Arab Emirates. On July 23rd, the Chinese mission Tianwen-1 was launched, and on July 31st, the Mars 2020 mission USA lifted off from Cape Canaveral. The history of the space race by the Emirates is very recent. The launch of their first satellite into Earth orbit dates back to 2009, while it was only in 2014 that a specific space agency was created, an initiative that in 2019 brought an astronaut from the Emirates to fly with the International Space Station. Now, a further step forward and another ambitious goal, if all goes according to plan, the Hope probe will enter the orbit of Mars on February 9, 2021. It will then begin to study the atmosphere through the use of three instruments, a high-resolution digital camera, an infrared spectrometer, and an ultraviolet spectrometer. The probe, a kind of weather satellite, is designed to study the planet's climate on a global scale, both on daily and seasonal timescales. It will also measure the distribution of hydrogen and oxygen in the outer atmosphere, trying to deepen the mechanisms that lead these two gases to disperse rapidly in space. The studies will help to understand the causes that have made the Martian atmosphere so thin as not to allow water to exist in a liquid state. If successful, the Emirates spacecraft will join six other orbiters from the United States, Europe, and India that are currently surveying Mars from orbit. The idea of promoting a mission to Mars did not come from scientific circles, but from the government of the Emirates itself, which wanted to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the country, inspire young people, and lead the Emirates towards a knowledge-based economy. And the mission is already bearing its first fruits, with the establishment of five new degree courses in scientific subjects and a growing enthusiasm for space on the part of children. Hope does not stand as an isolated initiative. but is the first stage of the Mars 2117 program launched by the Emirates 3 years ago, with the ambitious aim of establishing a human settlement on Mars within the next 100 years. And like the Emirates, China, with the mission Tianwen-1, name that means questions to the sky, is on the way to its first Martian exploration. Without forgetting, however, that in 2012, one of its probes destined for Mars in a joint mission with the Russian Phobos Grunt, the Yingwo-1, failed to leave Earth orbit and crashed later in the Pacific Ocean. Regarding the Tianwen-1, the Chinese government has, as usual, given very little information, and all that is known comes from published articles and reports of the state media channels that do not provide, for example, details on the budget or on the precise place where the probe will land on the planet. After the failure in 2012, China has achieved important results in the space race, such as in 2013, when the third country in the world after the United States and Russia landed on the moon with the Chang'e 3 lander and rover, and in 2019 when the Chang'e 4 lander and rover were the first in the world to visit the side of the satellite not visible from our planet. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell. You will help us to make products of even higher quality. Compared to the journey to the moon, the one to Mars is 1,000 times longer. But despite the possible greater difficulties, China has prepared for the occasion a mission with the same characteristics, consisting of an orbiter, a lander, and a rover, equipped with a total of 13 scientific instruments. Not many details are known about the instrumentation. It is known, however, that the orbiter will bring, in addition to high and medium resolution cameras, a magnetometer, a spectrometer to analyze the composition of the soil, and a radar for the subsoil. In April, 2.5 months after the arrival in orbit, scheduled for mid-February, the probe will detach the lander that will descend with the rover, 240 kilograms, a couple of meters long. The latter will explore with cameras, radar to investigate below the surface, spectrometers to analyze the composition of the soil and rocks, in search, it seems, of clues about life, both past and present. To touch the ground without problems, the lander is equipped with parachutes, retro rockets, and airbags. But the operation is not without risk. The gravity of Mars is more than twice that of the Moon, and unlike the Moon, the planet also has an atmosphere that, although tenuous, has an important role in the attitude of a probe landing. Once on the Martian soil, the rover, weighing about 200 kilograms, will begin to explore independently the surroundings, while the orbiter, which will also act as a communication channel, will rotate around the planet for at least an entire Martian year. The expected duration of the mission is one Martian year, equal to 687 Earth days, while the rover, powered by solar panels, has an expected operational life of 90 Martian days. The Martian day, said Sol, is 24 hours and 37 minutes. The rover is expected to rest in the Utopia Planitia, a vast flat region in the northern hemisphere, which, with an estimated diameter of 3,300 kilometers, is one of the largest impact basins in the solar system. In 1976, the Utopia Planitia was the endpoint of NASA's Viking 2 mission. But perhaps its most interesting aspect is that in 2016, thanks to information gathered by the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter mission, the U.S. Space Agency announced that it had discovered a large amount of water in the form of ice in the region's subsurface. The challenge for China is among the most daunting. Landing on the red planet is very difficult. Throughout the history of space exploration, a good half of the Martian missions have in fact ended in disaster. But if the challenge is successful, China will consolidate its role as a great space power. Future plans include the construction of a new space station, and in the next decade, a new Martian adventure to bring back to Earth some rock samples. After 8 years of preparation, the NASA Mars 2020 mission finally took off, which risked being postponed due to technical problems and the lockdown of the past months due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Perseverance is the fifth U.S. rover that will land on Mars. And if the first four, Sojourner in 1997, Spirit and Opportunity in 2004, and Curiosity in 2012, were designed for the exploration of the planet, the one that started on July 31st and should arrive on Mars on February 18th, 2021, will instead have the ambiguous task of identifying and collecting rock samples that a future recovery mission will then bring back to Earth in a decade. Its purpose will also be to characterize the climate and geology of the planet and to search for traces of microbial life in the past of Mars. Perseverance is a six-wheeled rover, 3 meters long, very similar to that of Curiosity, that for 9 years is still exploring the Gale crater. NASA's goal was to save money by using the same design with some changes, but failed to do so as the cost of the mission rose to $2.7 billion, almost $360 million over budget due to problems encountered in the development of some of the instruments, such as the sample caching system, which has the task of drilling autonomously the rock of Mars, extracting samples, and then hermetically sealing them in absolute sterile tubes that is completely devoid of any organic material of terrestrial origin that could alter future analysis. In terms of technology, it is the most complicated and sophisticated mechanism that has ever been built, tested, and prepared for a spaceflight. The collected samples are then transferred inside the rover to be finally deposited at the storage site. The site chosen for the rover's landing is the 45-kilometer-wide Yezero crater, just north of the Martian equator, and more specifically, the area that was once home to a lake and river delta. The area offers a rich variety of geological landscapes suitable for collecting samples that might contain signs of past life. And engineers of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California, have already mapped out several possible routes around the delta, on the order of about 15 kilometers in length. Among the innovative tools of the mission, it should also be noted the Ingenuity Mars helicopter that will have the purpose of making the first flyover of the planet. A challenging undertaking if you consider that the Martian atmosphere is about 100 times thinner than Earth's. Still bad news from Europe, which for the second time in a row had to postpone the departure of ExoMars, a joint mission between the European Space Agency, ESA, and the Russian space agency Roscosmos, to send to Mars the rover ESA Rosalind Franklin and the Russian lander Kazachok Kosak. The mission should have started from the cosmodrome of Baikonur aboard a Russian Proton rocket during the launch window last summer. Instead, due to yet another postponement, we'll be forced to wait for a date between August and October 2022, which will result in the lander descending to a region in the northern hemisphere called Oxia Planum, no later than the summer of 2023. Unfortunately, continuous delays in the development of some components, problems in interfacing with the Russian electronic systems, and finally the ongoing epidemic, have once again left on the ground this mission, designed in 2005 and should have already launched in the window of 2018. It's a pity not to have seen it launch together with the other missions. Also because there was a lot of anticipation to see in operation the large drill that mounted on the rover that would have to drill into the soil of Mars to a depth of 2 meters. Rosalind Franklin would have been the first Martian rover to be able to collect samples at such great depths, where it is thought that there could be life forms hiding to escape the sterilizing action of ultraviolet rays. Let's hope it can at least get there in 2023. If you like this video, you will probably also enjoy the others we published on the same topic: Perseverance on Mars, Splendid Mission, but Never-Ending Controversy, and Have We Overcome the Curse of Mars?